Hello VSDC users! Ever wondered how to make your text appear like it's glitching into existence? Today we will show you how to recreate this effect in VSDC. Let's get started! First, add your text to the scene and adjust the text size as needed. Duplicate your text and then for the bottom text object, set the text color opacity to 0 and change the contour color to white. Now, let's move to the top text layer. Go to the Video Effects Transparency and add a fade-in effect. Set its duration to about 4 seconds. This will make the fill gradually appear. To enhance this effect, you can use a pro technique by adding acceleration at the beginning. Make sure your fade-in effect is selected on the timeline, find the transparency parameter in the properties window, and switch the mode to Bezier curve. Select the first point and pull the Bezier handle to create initial acceleration. Then adjust the endpoint's Bezier handle to create a smooth deceleration at the end. Enhance the same top text layer by adding a recoloring text effect. Click this effect on the timeline, set the duration to 12 frames, and select Fade Out in the Effect Direction property. Then set Processing Order to Random. This will make letters disappear in a random sequence. To make them reappear in the same way, in the free version you'll need to duplicate the effect and change its mode to fade in. Pro version users can take it further by animating the transition level parameter. Click on the three dots next to it and switch to the Bezier mode in the key editor. Add a keyframe at the effect's midpoint and drag it all the way down while keeping the first point at the top. Now you can fine-tune the animation curve by adjusting the Bezier handles. Duplicate this effect and place it right after the first one. Go to its properties again and click Generate another map to randomize the letter appearance. Then head back to the key editor for the transition level parameter. This time, tweak the Bezier handles differently. It doesn't matter exactly how, just make sure the curve looks distinct from your previous one. Let's enhance the animation by creating multiple duplicates of the effect. Make several copies and arrange them sequentially on the timeline. For each duplicate, repeat the same randomization process you used for the second effect. Great! The result looks dynamic, but you'll notice the text abruptly snaps into place at the end. To fix this, we'll add a final recoloring effect. Place it after all the others and give it a slightly longer duration. Then, adjust the transition level curve to create a gentle, gradual reveal that smoothly completes the animation. Let's make the animation smoother. Select all recoloring effects and change their glyph drawing property to 400. For additional smoothing, go to Scene 0 and combine both text objects into a single sprite. In the Sprite properties, enable Apply Echo Filter and set the value below to 10. Perfect! One final touch. Color our text and background. Start with the background. Add a background template from the Templates window and move it to the bottom layer. Then go inside the text sprite and add another background template. Set its composition mode to Source In. If you need to change the text later, edit both layers separately. First, modify the top layer. Then hold Alt and click the text on the scene to select the bottom layer and update its text as well. Here's the final result. Let us know your opinion in the comments. Do not forget to like and subscribe.